Hi, this is MC Jetty, and in this video I'm going to demonstrate the new features of Lost Cities 2.0.0. So, first, world creation has changed. If you create a new world, let's call it Test 1. So you have the different world types. I'm going to choose Lost Cities Biomes of Plenty, and then the customize screen has changed a bit. You now get a preview, showing how it will look like approximately, and some description. So that's something that's new. So there are a few new world types. Let's start with this one. So that jungles in big glass bubbles on a barren landscape. So let's try it out. Create new world. So nearly there, I hope. So you spawn, make sure you spawn inside one of these bubbles, and let's go check here. And outside is wasteland. So let's go to spectator mode. So there are the cities inside these bubbles are also a bit ruined, but not as bad as outside. So this is the wasteland. There's still some lag because of world gen, but that will soon go better. So by default, the spheres can be relatively close to each other, but you can reconfigure that. You can also make sure that there is only one sphere and so on. There are a few options. But let me go check out the wasteland, because there are some cities here as well. But they are very, very much destroyed. So you see, the ruin level of the cities outside is much bigger than for the cities inside the big domes. So let's go inside one. That's another one. So this is one of the new profiles. Let's go try another one now. So another new type is floating. Cities on floating islands. So let's try it out. Just wait before everything loads. Again, the system makes sure you always spawn on an island. So basically, you have floating islands and cities that generate on these floating islands. World gen can sometimes be a bit weird, but overall, I think it looks okay. It's very hard to survive in a world like this, of course, especially in the beginning of the game when you don't have flight yet. If you're unlucky, you spawn on an island where there are even no trees or no buildings, so you can't do anything. So I think this kind of type of world is more suitable for special mod packs, or maybe to configure the dimension with it. But that's basically it. So another world type that is new. So let's now go to another new one, cavern. This is world a bit like the Nether. It goes up to 128. And, well, it's mostly pitch dark. So you'll see. World is still generating. And of course there's lots of stuff falling down. This will be a tough one to start in. Everything is present, in principle you can survive here. But it's dark and mobs will spawn immediately. I did make sure to put torches in the buildings though, so at least you have that. It's still generating chunks in the distance. When these are gone, sorry, it will be really dark. So here you see how it looks. Cities in the darkness with only occasionally sunlight. Let's enable night vision to give a better idea of the structure. So basically it's just like the Nether, it generates like the Nether, but there are even roads like this one. I think it could be a nice level for an adventure type map. So that's this type. Now let's try another interesting type. That's space. It's the same bubbles as with the biosphere, but this time the outside world is generated differently. So basically this is also a void type world. So this by chance is a sphere without any cities in, it's just a landscape, and there are monorail stations going to other spheres. Again, one. There are no buildings, but there are some street sections. Let's see what this one goes to. That's a crossing, so turn right and see what we end up here. Okay, here we have a city. So this could be a fun world to work in. What are those cows doing there? You can explore and see what's in the buildings. Also, torches are enabled in the buildings because I think it looks nice. But of course, that's all configurable. If you don't want it, you can always remove the torches. Okay, so that's this type. The last one is water bubbles. Same as before actually, but this time the world is flooded, not a void world. I spawned inside the building. Let's just go spectator. So you see the buildings that are at the same height, but go outside. There's a huge ocean here, and the city spheres are almost submerged. So now these are pretty dark. it generates a bit slower than the other type, the space type. Oh, and here's apparently got water in. Let's go check some of the spheres. World gen. Okay, it's there. So it's a bit slower, but once it's generated, it works pretty okay. So this is the final world, new world type that I'm going to show. Of course, these are all very, very configurable. You can try any kind of combination. So I hope modpack makers will work with this and try to make very nice modpacks using these new features. But basically, that's the idea. There have been a lot of other internal changes, but these are the most visual ones. Anyway, it's time to wrap up, and hope you enjoy it, and see you next time. Bye bye.